What's an angle? Well, one way to describe an angle is in terms of how far has one line segment rotated away from another line segment. Let's look at two line segments. This first one, this green line segment, let's call this the initial side. This other line segment, the red one, we'll call that the terminal side. Well, right now, the terminal side, the red line segment, has rotated 28 degrees away from the initial side. That's indicated by this little arrow showing we went up 28 degrees. Now, as the red line segment, the terminal side, rotates further away from the initial side, the angle increases. Now, there's a few important angles that are probably worth memorizing. The first one occurs right here. This is called a right angle. It's 90 degrees. Another one that's probably worth memorizing is when the terminal side has rotated all the way around to where it's horizontal with the initial side. This happens at 180 degrees. Now, way down here, 90 degrees later, we have 270 degrees. And finally, if we make a complete rotation all the way back to the initial side, we get to 360 degrees, which is really the same thing as 0 degrees. When we measure length, we have different units we can work with. This wiener dog is measured in inches, and it's also measured in feet. 18 inches is the same length as 1.5 feet, but we're using different units. Now we can also measure angles using different units. Right here is 40 degrees. We're measuring the angle in degrees. Now another very popular way of measuring angles is something called radians. So 40 degrees is actually 0.698131700 radians. And that number is actually rounded. The decimal place, these numbers here, would keep going over and over and over again. Most radian measurements are irrational values. Now, as we rotate the terminal side, we can see what different angles are in radians. Like right here, we have 2.05 and a bunch of numbers, radians. Now, you might be wondering, why would anyone ever use radians? This seems like a very awkward unit of measurement. Well, radians have an interesting property. Some of their angles are actually very easy to measure when we express the radians in terms of pi. Like, watch what happens as we approach what we know of as 180 degrees. Like, right now we're at 2.8, moving a little closer, 3. And when we get to 180 degrees, wow! 180 degrees is the same as pi radians. So 180 degrees measured in radians is 3.14 and a bunch of other numbers radians. Now let's think. If we rotated halfway around and we got to pi radians, how many radians do you think it takes to rotate all the way around to get back to your initial side? I'll leave that for you to figure out. Now, sometimes we want our angles measured in degrees, and sometimes we want them measured in radians. So it's necessary for us to learn how to convert from degrees to radians and from radians to degrees. So here's how we convert from degrees to radians. We multiply by pi over 180. Now, to convert from radians to degrees, we multiply by 180 over pi. So let's look at a couple examples. Suppose we have 60 degrees. Now, first we have to figure out, is this in degrees or radians? This one's kind of easy because that little tiny circle right there indicates that this is in degrees. So to convert it over into radians, we multiply it by pi over 180. So 60 degrees times pi over 180 turns out to be pi over 3 when we reduce. Now, what if we have an angle measurement like 5 pi over 3. This one's actually in radians, and our big hint is it has pi in it. To convert it back into degrees, we multiply it by 180 over pi. So 5 pi over 3 times 180 over pi, after we simplify, is just 300 degrees. This diagram shows some of the most common angular measurements that come up, and it shows them in both degrees and radians. For example, 30 degrees is in degrees. Pi over 6 measures the same angle in radians, and it's measuring the angle from this initial side, this black line here, up to this red line. All the way over here at 135 degrees, so if we went from here and rotated all the way to here, we have 135 degrees, or 3 pi over 4. Finally, if we rotated all the way around, here's the answer to our earlier question, we would get to 2 pi. So 360 degrees of rotation is equal to 2 pi rotation in radians. It might be worth pausing this video on this last image and copying this down.